Okay. So today, I said last time that I will discuss the next stage of this project. So until now, you were sketching. So you started with some initial basic ideas. Then last class, we looked at them and what needs to be developed further. And I hope that today you have selected at least one, two of them, which are the strongest ideas, which you can take to the next stage. So what is the next stage? Draw the chosen idea, the best, okay, in orthographic view. So what does this mean? We need scale 1:1. So we need the real size of the final clock that you're planning to do. Now, there is no specific size. It can be small, it can be a little larger, but I will talk about the material in a moment because sometimes you're limited with the size of the material. So I will discuss this in a minute when I start discussing the material. Just let me remind you that here you will see some examples, okay? Here, later you can look at them, some examples of student works. So it's something like this you need to do. So the paper size, this size is what? A2. A2 size. Size A2 Fabriano. You need A2 because when you draw the real size, scale 1:1, you will need space. Okay, so you cannot draw on the small paper. A2 size Fabriano. And how orthographic view, how you draw it? Front view, top view, two side views, and a bottom view. Okay? And we need to see all details accurately. So whatever details you have in the design must be drawn perfectly, not a sketch. This is technical drawing. So what you have here will go to the laser cutter later. So any line, any curve, any detail, you need to work out. So you take your sketch, the best chosen one, and you transfer it to scale 1:1 with modification, final modification of the details. Now, because your sketch is small, when you enlarge it a little bit, some of the details will look different and you need to clean up the lines. So if you have a curve, it needs to be a perfect curve. So don't draw freehand. Use French curves, use the flexible ruler. Use tools that will make your lines perfect. Okay? It needs to be freehand though, at this stage. I need a free, sorry, not freehand, a drawing drawn by hand, not a computer. Okay? So I need a version drawn with your hand. So don't for example, draw it on AutoCAD and give me an AutoCAD drawing, okay? Not acceptable for this class. Again, so we have A2 size Fabriano. Don't forget to put the border, 1.5 centimeters. Divide the borders, everything like we explained before. You will see some of the examples. Not all students made it 100% correct, but these are some good examples. And then you need to do the same like before. Print labels with front view, top view, bottom view, side views, the labels like in the previous project. And you will have, again, a table here with the information. What information needs, you can see what the students wrote and also in the syllabus. There is what I need. Now, there is a lot of examples here. So even drawings that have a lot of details and cares, everything must be drawn perfectly. Everything, and the pointers of the clock need to be drawn. Every detail, like from the side view, you will see. From the side view, okay, so this is the front. Then from the side view, you will see, for example, this device here at the back with the battery compartment. You will see, when you view it from the side, you will see part of these. Everything must be drawn according to the real correct measurements. So the front view, you will have a side view from here, another side view from here, a top view and a bottom view. And all these details must align perfectly according to the rules of orthographic drawing. So later on, see these examples. Overall, they're good examples. So you can see all these details are drawn carefully. So before you can draw these objects, okay, the pointers, this compartment here, you need to buy it. Because you need to buy it, you need to select the design that you want. There are several designs on the market, but you need to select the design you want and later draw it, because you need to measure it. Okay? So these things need to be bought and measured and put on the drawing. Okay. Very clean, very tidy orthographic drawing. The same requirements like in the first project. A scale 1:1 again. So what I see on that drawing, this will be the real size of the final product. Okay. This should be completed next class. So next class, everybody bring your final drawings completed in front of you, so that I can review and see what final modifications and changes you made to the sketch that you choose, and how it's going to look like. So, any final comments, any final changes, I will make on the orthographic drawing, okay? So it must be completed, at least 90% completed. The most important, the front view with all the details, and of course, at least one side view to see the thicknesses. Okay, the thicknesses, and if you are drawing correct. So, this is the last chance next time. So, the drawing on A2 paper in front of you, completed, almost completed. To see the final shapes and distribution. This is very important. Now, if I see your sketch again, I will not be able to give you any more feedback because it is a hand drawing. So we don't understand the thicknesses, we don't understand the details. But on the orthographic drawing, it will be clear. Any final mistakes must be fixed, okay? So, this one, bring next class. Don't forget, when you draw the orthographic drawing, that when you have, for example, a clock, okay? Here in the middle, there should be a hole. Okay. Don't forget this hole in the middle, because when you buy these pointers, these you need to stick them, okay, and wind them up. So you need a hole in the middle. So be careful this hole, okay, to be present in the drawing and later when you go and cut the material, to have a hole here. Now, what's the diameter of this hole? To be able to fit these materials, it should be around 1 centimeter or less, so 0.9, 0.8, measure them exactly, you need a little bit extra. So how much these pointers are, you put an extra millimeter so that they can enter. So around 0.9 should be fine. Some students make it a little smaller and it's still okay. So no problem. Just don't forget the hole, okay? It's very important. Okay. So now, I will talk a little bit more about the actual material, the acrylic. Because there are certain things you need to know about. Like most of the acrylic sheets that you will find in the market, they come in square sizes. So they come in square, okay? Like these sizes, 40 by 40 centimeter, okay? So, this will influence the size of your clock. Now, this doesn't mean you cannot make a bigger clock. You can make, but then you cannot cut it in one go. You need to have, for example, piece here, parts that you assemble, and it's going to be a lot more complicated. So if you have, if you want to cut something from one sheet, 40 by 40, it needs to be smaller than this size. Okay, this size or smaller. So don't make something, for example, 50 centimeters and expect to be able to cut it, because you cannot find the colored ones, especially. There is a transparent, so this is the colored. The transparent, there is a transparent sheet, okay, like this transparent, okay? These you can find bigger sizes. You can find, like really, maybe 1 meter by, I don't know exactly the size, but big, okay? So the transparent is available, but the colored ones with color, not available. Bigger than 40 by 40. Except if you find them from a place, I don't know, but I'm talking about the hardware stores in the region, Maktabe, these kind of things, they only have specific things, okay? Not everything you want. Also, the colors are limited. The color. So, for example, you will find maybe one blue, only one blue color. You will find white, you will find... for example, yellow, but you will not find another type of color. For example, close to this, lighter, darker, you will not find. It's like one color, okay? Orange, for example, you can find also. There's some colors like these. So it's like it's a mixture, it's not a clean color. So between blue and green, a mixture. But, you know, that's if you find it, and I'm not sure exactly which places sell what. Okay, so you need to go around several places and search and see what they have. Hardware stores, Maktabe, you search several, okay, and see. Because not everybody here has everything. But what I know, the colors are limited, not a lot of colors. You can find these kind of things are also allowed to be used, like a golden, okay, color, like a mirror, if you want for certain parts. There is also like silver, also mirror, like mirror, okay, but silver, not golden. So sometimes for some parts could be useful depending on your theme, depending on what you want to express. So, if you put the right, there is no ugly color or correct color. All colors are good. But where you put them in the design, the place, the location, how it, the color works with the shapes, how all this design works with your theme, all this result either in a good design or a bad design. So you need to pay attention. So I don't want anybody asking me, is this color good? Because I don't know, all the colors are good. It depends how you use the color. It's an element of design, like shape. All the shapes are beautiful, but how do you use the shape, one shape next to another shape, and what combination of colors, this is what makes the difference in the design, whether good design or bad design. So, pay attention to these things. Now, another thing, the thickness. The thickness of this material, it's very important. Thickness, okay? Thickness. So when you look at these materials from the side, let's take one. Okay, the thickness of this this acrylic material. There are several options. Now you have like 0.2 millimeter, 0.3 millimeter, until 0.5. Now, you are not allowed to use the thick ones. Like if you find, for example, 1 centimeter thickness, okay? Not allowed to be used. Use the thin ones, 0.2, 0.3. If you want to make a design that have a thickness, okay? You need to cut the same layer several times and glue on top of each other. And we have some here. examples. If you look at this here, this is look like half centimeter thick, but it's not. It's two layers cut with the same shape and glued on top of each other. Okay, it's safer for the laser cutter. Okay, because you're going to laser cut it, and I'm not sure about the machines and if they're going to cut perfectly. So use the thin material, and I'm even not sure that you will find a thick here. Okay, so the thin ones. If you want something thick, you just put more layers on top of each other. Okay. And if you have layers in the orthographic drawing, we need to see. Okay, we need to see from the side exactly what do you have, how many layers you have. So you need to put lines through them. So some of you will have several layers on top. Even it's part of the design. Like this student, this is the background layer, and these are other layers on top. This creates a beauty, like a three-dimensional view. So this here at the back, and then you have additional layers on the top. If it fits with your theme, with your sketches that you designed until now, this also creates extra beauty in the design. Of course, depending on what shapes you have, what combination of details, okay? So. These acrylic sheets, when you buy them, they come with a protective layer. It's like a sticker on the acrylic to protect the acrylic from scratches. Okay? Just be careful. The sticker paper, don't remove immediately and then scratch everything. Take it with the paper to the laser cutter, and after everything finish, okay, after you're sure that now it's the time to glue and assemble my product, then you take the protective layer off because you want it to be beautiful and shiny, not have scratches on them, okay? Or other imperfections. So pay attention. Okay. Now the glue. The glue, what glue can you use on these? This is very important. There is something called glue for acrylic or acrylic glue. Again, it can be found in the hardware stores. If you don't want to buy acrylic glue, you can use super glue, but you need to be very careful. Now, super glue, if you have, for example, super glue in general is safe to use when you have a color acrylic and you want to glue on a color acrylic. So in between here, if I put super glue, it's okay. Look at the back, I don't see any defect. It looks perfect. But if you use the transparent paper, acrylic, like this, for example. Transparent, look at the back, it's transparent. And super glue has been used to glue the black on the transparent. Then you will have it visible from the back, okay? So on the transparent, be careful. Be careful, because any super glue come on it, you cannot remove it. It's like it will permanently damage it. Like this student, do you see in this area, maybe here somewhere, some students, you will see by mistake, for example, they put a finger with super glue on it. So if the super glue touches the surface, it will make a mark. It will destroy it. So if you use the super glue, be very careful. For example, I want to glue something on top of something, an acrylic. Points, you know, small points. Point here, point here, point here, point here, point here. And you put, don't spray the glue on the, you know, because this is a shiny surface. It does not absorb the glue. So when you put two together, the glue spread. And you know what will happen if you put too much? It will come out from the edges. It will come out. And it will cause a disaster. So small, point, 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 point only. Huh? It's very strong and you don't need more. Huh? Be careful. Because I don't want you to cut everything beautifully and then glue and make a disaster. So, with the super glue, be careful. Now, acrylic glue, you can use it safely on the transparent. It will not cause any damage. So from the back, we will not see. But this is if you find, okay? Another thing, you have options. You don't have to use glue. You don't have to use any glue. You can, for example, have a design where you, for example, make holes. Okay, hole. You drill hole in here with the laser cutter, of course. And then you can use fasteners. What fasteners? Like these. For example, okay? And from the back, we will have this fasteners, okay? So you can fasten the sheets together with these. And there are acrylic fasteners. These are for metal, okay? Metal. You can use them. If I want, for example, a metallic kind of look, so the upper surface to have actually this piece visible here as a metal, okay. But there is acrylic fasteners, which are transparent, made from acrylic, and you can find them like, when they have presentation boards, and you see an acrylic piece, and at the back another acrylic piece, and in between, like space here acrylic, and here another acrylic, and they are fastened together with an acrylic fastener, okay, here and here. So these fasteners, they're very beautiful. They are designed for acrylic, and you can find them. So you can make a hole and fasten them with acrylic fasteners. They come in different sizes. You really need to go and see what they have. They have bigger ones and smaller ones. So you can put two sheets together with acrylic fasteners. And even in your design, you can make this space here. I don't know if it's part of the design, you can have a space in between sheets. So there are several options. You can glue sheets together of acrylic. You can use fasteners for metal or for acrylic. There are several options. You need to go to the hardware store and see. Because if I explain, it's not useful. You need to see what you have. Show me. Take samples. Try it. You know how it will work with your design. So you need a little bit of thinking and decision making process. Also in the hardware store, I already mentioned, you will buy these. They don't have a lot of options, but some of them are very complicated with a lot of cares and these kind of things, and some are more simple, like straight, you know. Again, you need to go around and see what they have. And also this. So the whole piece, you will buy it to put. Now, until now, I talked about the acrylic. But what other options do you have? So, acrylic plus what material you can use? There is a little bit of options here. So, acrylic use must be in your design 90%. It must be acrylic. Everything acrylic, all the parts. But you can have a few exceptions, like, for example, here, this student, this is acrylic, okay, this is acrylic, but here, some elements with sticker paper. You know, sticker paper come in different colors, different textures, so you can draw something on acrylic paper, but in a mirrored view, and then cut and also glue as part of your design. Now to make it better, you can have, for example, transparent acrylic, sticker paper, on top another transparent, so that this never gets damaged. And it looks like more beautiful than to see a sticker paper here. Like, for example, not beautiful to cut the numbers from sticker paper and put them here. Not beautiful as a final product. But if you put something from sticker paper, you glue, then put on top another transparent sheet to cover it, okay? Then it's a good design. So, sticker paper with the acrylic allowed to be used, but not everywhere. I don't want to see everywhere sticker papers, okay? A small quantity if you need. You can also use, like for these parts, for example. Oh, I just saw here this example. Do you see the student how they used fasteners for metal? You know, this is, and here it's fastened at the back. So, because this is a mechanical object, using metallic parts makes it more beautiful because it's suitable for the theme. Now, you can use other metallic parts. There are so many shapes, so many shapes of the head of the metal piece, so many. You can choose something and use it as, for example, to put it for the, instead of numbers, you know? So you can have something made out of acrylic or metal or another pieces that you find suitable for your design. So it all comes to, is it suitable for my theme and my design? And will it create beauty to the shape or not, okay? So these pieces that additional you can use it sparingly and with a good decision making. Like these small pieces, for example, you see, they're cut out of acrylic. But for example, they could have been made out of a metallic, for example, object here to be glued. So any additional objects you put, you glue, you can glue them on the actual design. Just be careful with the glue, okay? So if you put a little bit of super glue, and it's very small, the piece, just be very careful not to slip from your fingers or to touch any surface you don't want to glue. Just be careful with these details. So you have additional options to use. You can also use something else. I don't have an example here, but sometimes you have something specific, a specific picture from the internet. Like, for example, there was a student who wanted to use a picture of planet Earth, an actual picture, a photo, a cut photo from the internet, okay? So this is also allowed to be used, but again, very careful not to overdo it. You know, it's like a small part, I want a specific kind of texture or a specific image or something, I can print it from the internet on a nice paper, okay, a nice quality paper, cut it and put it in my design. But when you glue the paper here on top, you need an acrylic transparent sheet to cover it. If you don't cover it with a transparent sheet, it will look very cheap design, very bad. You know, so, okay, if I have a paper here and a little bit of water comes, it will destroy it. So it's not a good design. You need to cover it with a protective sheet on top. So also this is allowed to be used sparingly. Not big quantity, okay? A little bit in the correct location. Printed images, sticker paper, parts, metallic, acrylic, whatever, with specific shapes. You cut them on the laser or buy them ready. So there is many, many options. Now, anything you do, you decide to do, I need to see it on the orthographic drawing. All these decisions have to be made in this period so that you can add them to the orthographic drawing, okay? They need to be there. Any specific questions do you have to ask me? Anything not clear? So just keep these things in mind. If you have a question, ask me, please. Anybody want to ask me? Or everything clear? Everything clear? So next time what? We need the orthographic drawing here, ready. It doesn't have to be 100% complete. The most important, the front view design, And for example, one of the side views. Just to see.
One of the side views? Just one?
I mean the minimum for next time. Okay. The front view and one of the side views. So that if we need to make modifications on the front view, so that you haven't drawn, for example, all the side views and to have to repeat it. Yeah. One side view enough to give me an idea, are you drawing correct? Are you using the method correct? And the front view, which is this part of the design, the most important, because everybody will be looking at your design in this way, okay? Not from the side. So here is the most important what you will design, okay? So this should be ready next class, one scale 1:1 on A2 Fabrian. If there is a lot of mistakes and we need to make modifications, you will need to repeat it, of course, okay? We don't want it messy, we want it clean result. So have a look at the examples, just, you know, to get an idea. You need to print the stickers again and the box, like in the first project. And that will be it. Now, please sit, students, not now, okay? After I finish. Now, what will happen after? What will happen after? After what, the orthographic drawing is completed, and your colors are chosen, everything is ready. What will happen? This orthographic drawing that you draw by hand, using pencil, you need to transfer to some computer program. Okay, now, if you don't know how to deal with computer programs like AutoCAD, Illustrator, you can go and ask someone to help you. The same place which they cut laser, they have people who understand these things. You can ask who can transfer my orthographic drawing to a computer program to print it. Because each of these shapes need to be laser cut. Okay? So this will be drawn alone. This will be drawn alone. This will be alone. This will be the background alone. Okay, each piece will be cut separately on the laser, and then you will glue it together, or you will assemble it together. So, if you don't know how to draw this on Illustrator or on AutoCAD or these programs, there is one thing you need to have ready: your orthographic drawing with the correct everything, correct sizes, correct lines, everything, so that when someone takes it to help you, they can scan the drawing, okay, and use that to just draw the lines and to print. But if you don't have this, nobody can help you, because this is the design, okay, this is the design that needs to be transferred to the computer program. After it's transferred and printed, you will have a lot of pieces that you need to assemble. And then the project will be completed. You deliver the final product with the orthographic drawing. This is what I want for this project. This drawing and the final result. Okay? Thank you.